Everyone, in this lecture we are going to discuss about the event listeners. So event listener interfaces. So this is a part of the object-oriented design and programming offered by the Kerala Technological University in the fifth module. So what is an event listener? So we have already discussed about the event listeners in our previous sessions. So just go through what is an event listener. So event listener is an object that is notified when an event occurs. Okay, so event is happened at event source. When an event is occurred, it is notified to all the registered listeners. So for an event listener has two functions. First, it should register with one or more sources to receive notification about specific type of events. And second, it must implement the methods to receive and process these notifications. So all event listeners have two functionality. First, all the event listeners should register with at least one source. And if an event is happened at the source, so it is notified to the event listeners. If a notification is received by the event listeners, what the action to be performed is done in the implementation methods. And the general form to register an event listener is. So public void, add type listener. So here type specifies, the type indicates what is the type of the event which is going to happen. So if it's a keyboard interface, we have to give it as key listener. If it's a mouse interface, we have to give it a mouse listener. So based upon the type of the event, we have to specify the type here. So this is general syntax to register an event listener with an event source. For example, if we are to register a keyboard listener, this is a method add key listener. So if an event listener is already registered and we want to remove that event listener, we can use this method. So this is a general syntax to remove an already registered event listener from a source. So remove, here also the type indicates the type of the event. So if it is a keyboard event, you can give it as remove key listener. So this is the event listener. So event listener means it's an object which is notified when an event occurs, and we can register and remove the registered listener by using this syntax. So next we can look into the details of each listener. In the previous session we have discussed about different events in Java. So all events have the associated event listeners. So we look into the details one by one. So first we are going to discuss about the action listener. So what is an action listener? So before discussing about the action listener, first, what is an action event? So action event means it is generated when a button is pressed or list item is double clicked or a menu item is selected. So in these three conditions, it generates an action event. So if an action event happens, it is notified to the registered listeners. So if a notification is received by the registered listener, what it has to be done is implemented in the corresponding methods which is available in the listener interface. For the action in listener interface, we have, this is the method which is available in the action listener interface. So if a keyboard event, if a button is pressed or an item is double clicked or a menu item is selected, it generates the action event. So if an action event is happened, then what is to be performed is done by the action perform method. So we have to implement this method to do the operations when an action event is happens. So we can look into an example of this action event, then you will understand what action perform method. So what is the use of action perform method? Okay, this is an action listener interface, action listener interface implementation. And just run this program, then we look into the details of the code. So an applet is created. When I click the button, it displays button clicked one times. When I clicked it again, it shows button click 2 times. So the number of click is counted and it is displayed in the text box that is done in this program. Okay, so this program it implements the action listener. So action listener is implemented, and here we have two components. First one is a button and second one is a text field. So a text field is created by using this statement, and a button is also created, and these two are added into the frame. So add B means the button is added into the frame, and add text means we added the text box into the frame. Okay, and for every event listener we have to register it with the source. So the here the event listener is the action listener. So we registered the action listener with the button B. So this is by this statement we registered the action listener with the button B. Okay, so when an event happens we have to do some operations. In the action listener it is done by using the action perform method. Okay, in the action perform method I have counted the number of clicks and I displayed that string in the text box, so which is done here. So I counted the number of clicks and that number of clicks is displayed in the text box. Okay, since this is the general main method, here we created the object reference for this action listener action demo, and we set the size to size of the window, and we call the visibility to true. So this is a method. So here we implement the action listener. Action listener is implemented, and this class extension is for creating the frame, that frame window. Okay, so it's clear. So I will explain once more. So here we are implemented a class action listener demo by extending the frame and by implementing the action listener, and created two fields, a text field and a button field, and these two fields are added into the frame. So by using these statements, then also an action listener is registered with the button because the event is generated at the button. So we have to register the action listener with the event source. So action listener is registered with the event source button, and when the action is performed, which is dictated by this action performed method, so the operation to be performed on an event which is written here. So once again I run this program. So when I run this program it will look like this. So we created two frames, a text box and a button. When I click the button automatically it comes to this action perform, and here the number of click, first number of click is 1, so number of clicks variable gives 1, and the button click number of clicks 1, so button clicked 1 times. So when I click it again, so now it's the counter incremental, button clicks 2 times. So that is so every time when I click this button, this action performed method is executed. Okay, next listener is the adjustment listener. Adjustment listener is associated with an adjustment event. So what is an adjustment event? The event which is generated when a scroll bar is manipulated. Whenever a scroll bar is manipulated, whenever a scroll bar is moved, it generates an adjustment event. So that adjustment event is handled by the adjustment listener. So adjustment listener deals with the adjustment event generated by the scroll bar, and this event is handled by using this method. Adjustment value change method. So adjustment value change method is available in the adjustment listener, and this method is used to do the operations we have to perform when an adjustment event happens. Okay, so adjustment event is happened when a scroll bar is manipulated. If a scroll bar is manipulated, the adjustment event notifies all the listeners registered with that source, and the registered listeners receive the notifications, and it performs the operation which is written in the adjustment value changed method. Okay, so in the example, so this is an adjustment listener demo example. So we have to import the AWT and AWT event here, and we are going to create a scroll bar. So created the variable scroll bar, and in the constructor we set the title of the scroll bar. So title of the scroll bar is now set to adjustment listener demo, and we set the layout of the demo. Then that scroll bar is added to the window. So and the preferred size of the scroll bar is set to see the changes, and this is the listener interface. So adjustment listener interface, in the previous slide we have discussed that add type listener is the general method. So here the type is adjustment. So we added the listener to the scroll bar SB. So SB dot add adjustment listener. So this will add an adjustment listener. This will register an adjustment listener with the scroll bar button. So these values are set to size of the variable. And every time when we scroll the scroll bar, the title of the scroll bar will change. That is the output of this program. So when we run this program, we'll get a scroll bar like this. Okay, and we set the title of the scroll bar as scroll bar with adjustment listener demo. So this is the title we set first. So when we move the scroll bar, so I am going to move the scroll bar. The scroll bar is moved. So look at here. So here the value change happened. So look at here. The value is changed. The current position of the scroll bar is deleted. So when I move the scroll bar, it will generate an adjustment event, and due to that adjustment event, the registered adjustment listeners receive a notification. When an adjustment listener receives a notification, what to be performed is written in the adjustment value changed method. So the adjustment value changed method will act based upon the value. So here I am just displayed the current scroll bar value in the title. So the title of this applet is set to get current value. Clear? To discuss is the item listener. So item listener is associated with an item event. And when it is happen? It is happen when a checkbox or list item is clicked. Also occurs when a choice selection is made or checkable menu item is selected or deselected. In all these conditions, it generates an item event, and this item event is managed by the item listener. And item listener also has one method, one implemented method. Item listener interface have this method, and the name of the method is item state change. When there is an item event is happen, what is to be performed based upon this item event is discussed, is implemented in the item state change. So whatever the statement which is written in the item statement, item state change is executed when an item event is happen. So here also we have to register the item listener with the item event source. Look into an example of the item listener interface. So this is an example for the item listener interface. So here we created three checkbox. So when we run this program, this is the output of the program. So here we have created four checkboxes. So Windows, Android, Solaris and Mac. These are the four checkboxes we have created. And two of the checkbox status of the Windows checkbox and Android checkbox is set to true. So it is already by default it is ticked. And other two checkboxes, Android and Solaris, Mac OS, this is set to false. No argument is passed to these two checkboxes, so by default it is false. So when I check this, uncheck this Windows, so the status of this Windows will be changed to false. When I uncheck this Android, it is false. When I check Solaris, it becomes true. When I check Mac OS, it becomes true. When I check Windows, Android. So when a but checkbox is checked, then it generates an item listener event, item event, and it is notified by the item listener. Okay. So this is a program for that. Here we created for checkboxes, and this is for set the this is to set the font size so that you can visible. So that it is visible to all of you. So for that I have just used a font for all this will be will learn all this about these fonts and all this in the upcoming sessions. So the four checkboxes added into the screen, and for each checkbox we have to add a listener. So we have four checkboxes. So here we added listener to each checkboxes. So item listener to the Windows checkbox. So the item listener is registered with the Windows checkbox. Also item listener is registered with the Android checkbox. Item listener is registered with the Solaris. Item listener with the Mac checkbox. So all checkboxes. So the item listener is registered with the all the sources. And for this, when we get the current state. So current state of the checkbox is get by using this get state method, and which is added to the message, and that message is written in the output screen. That is about the item state change listener. It's clear. Key listener. Key listener is associated with the key event. So when the key event is generated. Key event is generated when an input is received from the keyboard. Okay, and compared to the previous listeners, here we have more methods associated with the key listener interface. In the key listener interface, we have three methods: key pressed, key released, and key typed. So in a keyboard, we can press the keyboard, we can release the keyboard, and also during the operation, we'll type something, some letters. So in order to handle all this, we have three abstract methods which is available in the key listener interface to handle the key event. And next, the example of the key event. So for key event, so this is the next, this is an example for the key event. So in this example, when we press any character A, E, I, O, U, it will display the corresponding message. If we press the A, it will display A for apple, E for elephant, and if we prep any key except A, E, I, O, U, then it will show you have the type only vowels. So we have to type only vowels. So this is the program I have written in this for this example of for demonstrating the example of key listener. So key listener, we have three abstract methods. So you have already studied about the interface. If the interface contains the interface only contains the abstract methods, so if we implement any interface, we have to expand all the methods, all the abstract methods which is available in the interface. In the key listener interface, as we have already discussed, we have three key methods, but here in this program I have only used the key typed method. Even though I used the key typed method, I have to give I have to write the these two methods here, because otherwise it will throw an error, because all the elements in the all the methods in the interface is not implemented. So we have to write it. It is an empty method. We are not performing anything with this method. We are only performing with the key typed method. Okay, so run this program. Run this program. Okay, and click it. When I type something, for example, if I type A, it will display A for apple. If I click the button B, it will shows you have to type only vowels. If I type E, it will displace elephant. So it identifies the key press. Key typed is identified by this applet. Okay, so we implemented the key listener interfaces in this example program, and we have registered the key listener here. So this is a method to register the key listener, and we expanded the key type method. So when a key pressed event is happen, when a keyboard event is happen, what have to perform is written in the method, so which will display the corresponding text in the output screen. So this is an example for the key listener. So it's clear. So this is, we implemented the key listener, we added the listener with the this object, because we have created this means we are currently referring to the currently active instance of the object, and all the elements we pressed is displayed in the screen. Okay, so you can see all these demo programs in my GitHub page, which is available in the description of the video. And the next listener is mouse listener. So in the mouse listener, actually mouse have two types of event and two different types of listener in the mouse. So here we are discussing about the mouse event. So a mouse event is generated when a mouse is dragged, moved, clicked, pressed or released. It's also generated when the mouse enters or exits of a component. So in every condition, it generates a mouse event. And in the mouse event, mouse listener has different methods associated with them. So these are the abstract methods which is available in the mouse listener. So these abstract methods are mouse clicked, mouse pressed, mouse released, mouse entered, and mouse exited. So we can, so if a mouse is entered into a screen, what we have to perform, we have to write it here. If a mouse is exited from a window, what we have to, from the frame, then what we have to do is write in this mouse exited form. When a mouse clicked, what we have to perform is we have to write in this method. Mouse is pressed, mouse is released, so everything. We have different methods to handle the mouse events. So five mouse event methods are there in the mouse listener class. Also, this is another class, mouse motion listener class. Motion listener interface, not class, it's an interface. Mouse motion listener interface. Here it is handled by the mouse moved method and mouse dragged. For mouse dragging and mouse moving, we have another set of another type listener method. It is mouse motion listener method. In the previous one is the mouse listener method. In the mouse listener method, we have mouse listener interface. We have mouse clicks method, mouse pressed method, mouse released method, and these are the five methods which is available in the mouse listener interface. And in mouse motion listener interface, we have two more methods. So if we want to implement all these seven methods, we have to implement the mouse listener and the mouse motion listener. In the next example, we are going to implement these two listeners, in the mouse listener and mouse motion listener. There is one more listener in the mouse, associated with the mouse, but it is associated with another event. So previously it was the mouse event. So previously it was the mouse event. So for the mouse event, we have two listeners, mouse motion listener and the mouse listener, which is associated with the mouse event. And mouse wheel event, we have another listener, mouse wheel listener, which is used to track the mouse wheel. So in the mouse we have a wheel. So we have track the mouse wheel movement by using the mouse wheel move method, which is available in the mouse wheel listener interface. Okay, so once again we can check what are the listeners available in the mouse. So in the mouse we have two types of events, mouse event and mouse wheel event. In mouse event we have six method associated with two listeners. First one is the seven methods. First one is the mouse listener interface. In the mouse listener interface we have five abstract methods. In the mouse motion listener interface we have two abstract methods, and in the second event, that is mouse wheel event, we have mouse wheel listener interface, and in the mouse wheel listener interface we have one method. So totally for handling the mouse of mouse movement we have 5 + 2 + 1, that is 8 methods available in the mouse wheel mouse movement to detect the mouse movement. This is a mouse listener demo. So in this mouse listener demo I have implemented two listener interfaces. The first interface is the mouse listener interface and second interface is the mouse motion listener interface, and these interfaces are registered with the current object. So add mouse listener, add mouse motion listener. So these two interfaces are registered. These two listeners are registered with the object, and the set background color is set to black. So here I am using different colors to indicate whether the mouse is dragged, mouse is moved, mouse entered or mouse exited from the screen. So all these are indicated by using different colors. So mouse entered. So the method mouse entered is expanded here. When the mouse entered into the frame, the color will change to magenta and it will display the mouse entry. And mouse exited from the screen, then the color of the screen will change to black and it will show the mouse exited method. The mouse is pressed, it will show the text SJCET with a color green, background color green. If the mouse is released, it will show the text engineering with the background color blue. If the mouse is moved, it will show a display college with color white. If the mouse is dragged, then it will show the current X and Y position of the mouse. When it is clicked, it shows student. So different methods, the different abstract methods which is available in these two interfaces, that is the mouse listener interface and the mouse motion interface, is implemented here. What we have to perform when this when the mouse event is happen is explained here. And the mouse clicked, it will show us the pink color. You just run this program. So and we'll look into one by one. First one is mouse entered and mouse exited. Mouse entered and mouse exited. Okay, so mouse exited. So mouse exited means the color is black. Here it is displayed. So here it is, the currently the background is black. When the mouse is entered, it will show the white color. Okay, mouse is dragged, mouse is entered. So here when the mouse is moved, it will show. When the mouse is exited, it shows mouse is exited. It is displayed here, mouse is exited, and the color will be given as the back color. When I click it, it will show the green color and the text SJCET. So when the mouse is pressed, it will show a green color and the text SJCET. Mouse is pressed, it shows a green color and it SJCET. And the mouse is released, when it shows students, so mouse is clicked. Okay, so it mouse clicked, mouse is now it is in the currently press stage, so it is shows green color and SJCET, and here the mouse is clicked. So it will show different types of actions based upon the mouse operations. So you can see this source code in my GitHub page, and the link of the GitHub page is available in the video description. So next we can look into the last important listener interface, that is text listener interface. The text listener interface which is associated with the text event class, and the text event, even when the value of text area or text field is changed, then the text event is generated. When a text event is generated, it is handled by using the text listener interface. And this is the method which is available, the abstract method which is available in the text listener interface, void text value change. So if the value is changed, we can perform something by using this text listener interface. So the last example in this video lecture, so we are going to check what happened when a text listener is implemented. So in this program I have implemented the text listener interface. So text listener interface is implemented here, and so this is the syntax to generate a text box. We'll look into about the details of these components in the next module, sixth module. First part is about the different components which is available in the applet. So we'll discuss about these components there. So this is the general syntax for creating a text field, and we add the text field text listener to the, we register the text listener to the text field, and we added the text field into the output screen. Okay, and the method we have discussed is text value change. So in the text value change, what I did is I set the title of the text with the key typed. So when I type some key, when I entered some text value change happens in the text area text field, then it will be notified in the title bar of the applet. So just look into the example. Okay, so this is a text field. So I am going to that text field is going to change by typing some character, and all these characters are displayed here, right? So if I create A, if I remove all these A, B, C, so everything is displayed in the title bar. So when there is some change happens in the text, it is notified by the text field listener, and based upon that notification, the corresponding operation to be performed in the text value change. Okay, so that's about the listeners listener interfaces which is available in the Java. These are on some of the important listener interfaces which is available in Java. There is lots of other listener interfaces are also available in Java, but we discuss only about the basic listener interfaces. So I hope you get something. So if you have any doubt, please refer the slides which is available in the Google Drive, and the source code which is available in the GitHub. Thank you.